Hello, with Annette here. Welcome to another of my videos about movie production gone wrong. You just cannot get the stuff. They came to Cordura. Robert Rossen directed this 1959 Western, which was based on the 1958 novel written by Glendon Swartout. Glendon served in France during World War II. He was part of the 3rd Infantry Division. While there he witnessed Medal of Honor citations, which inspired him to write his novel. This movie was the producer William Goese's second movie in a 6-picture deal with Columbia, which with a $4.5 million budget, it became the most expensive production for Columbia at the time. Filming took place in California's Indio, as well as Harrisburg and Snow Canyon in Utah. Dick York, who is well known for playing Darren Stevens in Bewitched, accepted the role of Private Renzihausen in this movie. Dick and Gary Cooper, who played Major Thomas Thorne, were filming a scene that contained a handcart that was being propelled downhill on rail tracks. The handcart contained military personnel that were wounded. When Robert shouted cut, Dick was just lifting up the handle as a wounded cast member reached the handle. This caused the 180-pound cart to bear its weight on Dick's neck. This incident tore muscles in his neck. This later caused Dick to give up his role in Bewitched, and due to his addiction to painkillers, eventually caused him to lose his career as an actor. Arguments, protests and an accident. Spartacus. Directed by Stanley Kubrick. This 1960 historical movie was based on Howard Fast's 1951 novel. Howard had to publish his own novel after it had been blacklisted. They tell a story about the life of Spartacus as he leads the slaves in a revolt against the Romans, which adapts into the Third Servile War. Kirk Douglas, who played Spartacus, owned his own company Briner Productions, which Kirk named the company after his mother. After Kirk had been persuaded to read Howard's novel by Briner Productions Vice President Edward Lewis, which led Kirk to be fixated on the story, and with Kirk's own finances he purchased an option of the book. To allow Kirk to concentrate on acting for this movie, Edward became the producer, and Kirk became the co-producer. Kirk originally hired Anthony Mann after David Lean rejected the offer to direct this movie. But a week into the production Kirk fired Anthony. It did not take long for Kirk to find another director as he already had worked with Stanley. Howard was hired at first to write the storyline. As Howard could not work with the format needed, Kirk decided to hire a blacklisted screenwriter Dalton Trumbo who had been imprisoned in the 1950s for Concept of Congress. Since Dalton's release he had been writing screenplays under a different alias, however, to help get Dalton recognized once again Kirk announced that Dalton was writing for the production. Even the president at the time, John F. Kennedy, crossed the picket lines of a demonstration that was held by American Legion to see the production, to help Dalton's reputation from the blacklist and was credited for his work. Some people praised Kirk's invention for helping Dalton get off the blacklist. Kirk would have liked Jeanne Moreau, a French actress, to play the role of Varinaya, but Jeanne did not want to leave her boyfriend alone in France at the time, so Kirk decided to ask Sabine Bathman, a German actress, but Stanley gave Sabine $3,000 to go home, as Stanley thought Sabine did not suit the part. Universal Studio financed this movie after Kirk managed to get two men on board, which were Olivier Lawton, who played Gracchus, who also helped direct the picture, and Peter Ustinov, who played Batiatus. At the same time this Spartacus was in production, another Spartacus movie was in development for United Artists by Yul Brynner, which Universal Pictures won the race when their production ending after 2 weeks with Kirk and Dalton's help. With a budget of $935,000, which quickly escalated to $12 million since there were 10,500 cast members alone. This production was filmed at California's Death Valley and Wildwood Regional Park in Thousand Oaks. Also, scenes were filmed at Mount Clef Ridge close to California Lutheran University, and a vast plain just outside Madrid. A 35mm Super 70 Technirama format, which helped the film to be blown up to 70mm. This was something new for Stanley, as he was used to using the spherical standard format. Stanley wanted the production to be filmed in Rome and hire cheap extras. However, Universal's president Edward Mull wanted the filming to take place in Spain. To create the large crowd scene, the crew used a three-channel sound system to record 7,000 to 6,000 people that were spectating a Notre Dame College football game, and to add extra authenticity, the crew got the crowd to shout "Hail, Crassus," and "I'm Spartacus." 4 Academy Awards were gained for this production, which were Best Art Direction, Best Cinematography, Best Costume Design and Best Supporting Actor. Spartacus also became the highest money maker at the time for Universal Studios. This move was selected for preservation in the United States National Film Registry by Library of Congress in 2070, for being culturally and historically important. Despite this, there were many confrontations between Stanley and the cinematographer, Russell Metty, as Russell disagreed with the use of lighting and the unusual detailed instructions of camera work. The arguments became so intense Russell threatened to quit the production. That is not the only person Stanley had arguments with. Dalton and Stanley often clashed over the screenplay, but that is not only what brought this movie into this list. Charles McGraw, who played Marcellus, suffered a broken jaw while filming the scene of the gladiator revolt. During the scene, Kirk grabbed hold of Charles's head and forced it into a pot of soup. While doing so, Charles got his head stuck in the rim of the pot. Luckily for Charles, he was able to continue filming. There could be a price to pay for beauty. The Guns of Navarin. Directed by J. Lee Thompson, this 1961 war movie is based on a novel by Alastair MacLean, which was published in 1957. Both the novel and movie are about the Allied commando unit that is tasked to destroy a German fortress that attacks Allied vessels in the Aegean Sea. Carl Foreman, who wrote the screenplay and helped produce this movie, also wanted to direct. However, Columbia Pictures denied Kyle's request as they wanted an Englishman to direct the picture. The job of director was originally given to Alexander McKendrick, but due to creative differences between Alexander and Kyle, it forced Kyle to take action and fire Alexander. Since Gregory Peck, who played Captain Keith Mallory, was impressed by a movie that J. Lee Thompson had previously directed, he suggested that J. Lee should be hired as director of The Guns of Navarin. This movie was part of the top-budget World War II adventures that included The Bridge on the River Kwai, The Great Escape and The Longest Day. After the head of Columbia Pictures Mike Frankovic was impressed with the novel, he saw inspiration of it becoming a film. At first Kyle could not share Mike's enthusiasm, but eventually Kyle changed his mind. Despite the difficulties Kyle knew he would face for this production, Kyle also added his own adaptations by changing the gender of the local resistant fighters, and Kyle also invented a conflict between Gregory's character and Anthony Quinn's character, which Anthony played Colonel Andrea Stravos. Majority of the filming took place on the Greek island of Rhodes, where a base for the whole production team was placed in 1960. Which took 2 months to build. Some scenes were also filmed on Gozo Island near Malta, as well as Tino Island in the Ligurian. Anthony became fascinated with the landscape of Rhode Island, which influenced him to buy some land. To this day it is known as Anthony Quinn Bay. Also, if anyone visits Albany, New York, do not forget to check out the destroyer USS Slater, which is now a museum. But USS Slater was used in this movie too. Gregory Peck was expected to speak fluent German for this production, because Gregory was not convincing enough, his voice had to be dubbed over with the voice of Robert Riotty. A British team Hallers and Batchelor, which were best known for their animations at the time, created the maps for this movie. However, many people think the island of Navarin is a fictional place, but the island actually does exist and is known as Antikythera Island. Also, while filming the Mandrakos Cafe scene, the Greek royal family visited the film set. They can also be seen in the background as extras. But not all the filming went so well. While David Niven, who played Corporal John Anthony Miller, was shooting scenes in a dirty pond under the cave elevator, which led David to be hospitalized with sepsis, which many of the cast members thought the production would never be finished, but attempts were made as scenes were filmed where David was not needed. A time came though where discussions were made to whether the production should be abandoned and claim the insurance. David though had other ideas. Against the doctor's orders, David returned to the production so filming could commence. However, it did not take long for him to be hospitalized once again with sepsis. Luckily, the filming of his scenes were wrapped up. Sometimes conviction is not enough. Flower on the Stone. This 1962 Russian drama was originally named Thus Nobody Loved. It was first directed by Anatoly Slesarenko, but he was prosecuted and convicted for the death of Inna Berdychenko. Inna was caught in a fire during the scene of burning barracks on July 30, 1960, which left her with third-degree burns. She spent time hospitalized till her death on August 15, 1960. Inna was also 3 months pregnant at the time. The new director Sergei Parajanov decided to finish the production and also change the title. Evil or Good? The Unforgiven. John Huston directed this 1960 Western, which is based on the 1957 novel by Alan LeMay. It was filmed in Durango, Mexico, which is the last movie for Hite Hill Lancaster production. The project had an original budget of $3 million, which quickly bloomed to $5.5 million. Dulbert Mann was originally hired as director for the production before John Huston took over. John also wanted Richard Burton to play the role of Cash Zachary, but Richard demanded to be paid the same as Burt Lancaster, who played the leading role of Ben Zachary, but Richard was swiftly denied his demand and was replaced by Audie Murphy. It was not the only cast that had a change. The original screenwriter J.P. Miller was replaced by Ben Maddow. John Hudson wanted Oswald Morris to be his cinematographer, but as Oswald was unavailable at the time, the position was given to Franz Planer, but John held many years of resentment against Oswald for not taking up the position. John Saxon had signed a 3-movie contract with the production company. However, John Saxon's scenes were taken out during editing without John Hudson's consent. The movie tells a story of racism that was held towards Native Americans during the times of the Old West, which led to many feuds between Hite Hill Lancaster and John Hudson. John wanted to highlight racism across America, as the production company wanted it to be more commercial and less controversial. Neither managed to gain their way with this movie. Carlos Rivas played the Lost Bird. The saying Lost Bird became adopted by the white people, which is given to orphaned Native American children, after the white man went in guns blazing and killed all the Native American adults, just like what happened to the child named Zinkela Nooney, who was a Hunkpapa Lakota survivor. After her mother and father were brutally killed by the force of the white hand, Leonard Wright Colby thought he was doing the right thing by adopting Zinkela and raising her as a white girl alongside his wife Clara Bewick Colby. A foundation was created called the Lost Bird Society, which helps those children that were forcefully taken to find their true families. This production was not a smooth one, as a serious problems occurred while filming. In 1959, production had to be halted as Audrey Hepburn, who played Rachel Zachary, fell off a horse and broke her back during rehearsals, which led Audrey to spend 6 weeks in hospital, Unfortunately, this accident also caused Audrey to have a miscarriage. Audrey did return to the production, however, when she fell pregnant again, Audrey took time out from acting, as Audrey blamed herself for the miscarriage. Which led to John Hudson to say it was the worst movie he made of all time. Thank you for listening. If you like my content, please like and subscribe. To keep up to date with future videos, then press that notification bell, alternatively follow me on Twitter @withanet1.